Our coverage here on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications, brings us to sectional number 44 tonight, home of the Southmont Mounties. They've actually got a bye, so we won't see them until Friday night. Game one of this sectional features the Cascade Cadets and the Monrovia Bulldogs. You see the graphic on your screen. Cascade coming in at 7-15, Monrovia at 9-14. As we welcome you into our pregame show, Sean Walker, Pete Gasho here to set the stage for you. Petey, it seems like basketball season just started yesterday and we're approaching the end. The tournament officially begins tonight. It is March 1st already. Can you believe it?
I cannot believe it. It's a very exciting time of year for Indiana basketball and getting into sectionals. Weather outside's perfect for it. We're starting to get some nasty weather. Usually happens when it's sectional time, so
it's
go figure.
It's supposed to be closer to spring break. I want the warmer temperatures to come back. These two teams obviously play in different conferences. Monrovia is in the Indiana Crossroads Conference, and Cascade plays in the WIC, the Western Indiana Conference. We showed you their records conference-wise on the graphic a moment ago. These two teams played each other during the regular season. It was Monrovia losing to Cascade 55-59 in that matchup. But a lot of times when you play a game earlier in the season, you can throw that out in sectional time. We've seen that all year long with our coverage here on MTC Sports. Let's talk about our impact players. First up, let's go with the visiting team, the Cascade Cadets.
Well, the Cascade Cadets, you got number 34, Evan Birch, the junior guard, 6'2", averages 12 points a game and 5 rebounds.
On the other side for the Monrovia Bulldogs, their impact player tonight.
On the other side, Luke Sieber, the junior forward, 6'5", 15.6 points per game, and he averages 6 rebounds.
Look for those two battled out on the hardwood tonight and chip in, have an impact for their team. Let's throw up the tournament bracket real quick if we can. Let's take a look at this sectional here at Southmont and how it's going to play out. You got the 6 p.m. game tonight with Cascade and Monrovia, followed by the next game that we'll have for you here as well, North Putnam and Cloverdale. South Putnam and Southmont both drew the bye, so they won't play until Friday. That's kind of a benefit to them. Hopefully they can get a win, or, you know, these two teams looking to get a win and then immediately put themselves right into a championship game at 7 p.m. on Saturday night. Sectionals kicking off all across the state of Indiana. It's an awesome time of year. It's Hoosier hysteria for a reason. With that, let's talk about our keys to victory for tonight's matchup, what these two teams need to do well against each other to come out of here with a win.
You want to contest your outside shooters. Last time these two teams met, Monrovia shot 43% from the outside, and Cascade went 3 of 11 for 27%. So one of those guys getting it done. And then on the number two is free throw shooting. You got to win again. We get in a game like this, it could get down, especially like the last game. It was really close, 59-55. So sometimes you end these games and you find yourself at that line. So it's really important to concentrate and make those free throws. And neither one of these teams score a whole lot of points. So in our opinion tonight, first one to 50 gets the victory.
Yeah, I like your keys a lot. Free throws are going to be huge in this game. Neither team shoots exceptionally well from the charity stripe. Both teams in that mid-60% range. So whoever can convert there tonight will probably get out of here with a win. It's going to do it for our pregame show. Both teams are finishing up their warmups. They'll do the national anthem here. When we come back, we'll get our starting lineups and the tip-off. You're watching Indiana High School Basketball right here on MTC Sports.
Gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish. For
High-speed internet is only a click away. Through fiber optic technology, Endeavor Communications is able to offer internet speeds up to 1,000 megabits per second to stream movies, download music, watch TV and video clips, connect on social media, play games online, conduct online video conferencing, and is ideal for supporting all your devices in your home or business. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Provides outstanding IT and computer-related services for your home or business. Whether you need a simple home PC tune-up or a large-scale network installation for your business or your municipality, Endeavor eTechs is your final destination for all of your IT needs. Maintenance agreements are available and services open to members and non-members alike. Call 1-877-524-9109 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
I don't think of this as a high school weight room. It's more like a high school classroom. I'm learning how to manage my time here. I'm learning that it's important to have goals and that it takes persistence and commitment to reach them. And I'm learning that the best way to lead is by example.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Want to know what I like best about playing basketball for my high school? I like it because it's a place where my friends get to see me play. I like it because I'm playing for someone besides myself. I'm playing for everybody in my school and every person in my community.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Welcome you back to Southmont High School in Crawfordsville, Indiana for sectional 44 quarterfinals. Game one features Cascade Cadets. Monrovia Bulldogs are getting their starting lineups in right now. First up for the Cascade Cadets, their starting lineups will look like this tonight. It'll be Brock Stevenson and Zach Butler and Evan Burchett, your guards. Alec Alderson and Dalton Dubois will be your forwards for Coach Chris Dubois. 101-163 record overall in his time here at Cascade. Good look at the Cadets. On the other side of the court, Monrovia Bulldogs, their starting lineup tonight will be John Williams, Luke Smith, Trevor Eisenhoop. This will be your backcourt. Front court will be Luke Sieber, our impact player for tonight's game, and McCoy Davis. Micah Elliott, the head coach, 27-64 overall record for the Monrovia Bulldogs. Again, this is game one of two that we'll bring for you tonight. Game number two will feature the North Putnam Cougars versus the Cloverdale Clovers. We've seen all of these teams except for Southmont this season in previous games. We'll get to see the Mounties on Friday night. One team to look out for sure is Cloverdale. They got the Lieber State Park Splash Brothers, their own version of Steph Curry and Klay Thompson.
Two young men that can light it up in a second, you know.
Looks like jumping it up in the middle will be Dalton Dubois and McCoy Davis. Monrovia wearing the home whites, Cascade in the visiting black jerseys. Dubois wins the tip to Butler. And Birch will set up the offense for the Cadets. Be picked up early by John Williams. Man-to-man defense. And we get our first turnover of the basketball game. Cascade shuffling some feet. Setting it up a point for Monrovia will be a Trevor Eisenhoop. You get down low. There's our first foul of the ball game. So already Cascade with a turnover and then commits their first foul. That's going to be against Dalton DuBois. It'll be his first.
Get to look at it right there on the replay. Just reaches up and gets him with a hand.
Free throw opportunities for Luke Smith. He misses the first. That's a rare miss for Luke. He's an 89% free throw shooter. He's, I hate to say the only, but he's one of two free throw shooters on this team that are keeping that free throw percentage up around 60% for the team. Him and Sieber, really good free throw shooters. Yeah, the rest of the team struggling a little bit from the line. 1-0 early score. Monrovia staying in that man-to-man defense. Really want to pressure the outside shooters of the Cascade Cadets. They get it to Birch. Birch outside to Boy, going to let a three go from the corner. His first offering, no good.
Good block out. Good rebound.
Williams thought about it. Two-three zone for Cascade. They're going to let Monrovia shoot the three here. Caromed around to Boy with his first rebound. They get it back to Stevenson in the corner.
Oh!
There's your first three-pointer knockdown for Cascade. 3-1 early score. Pull-up jumper on the baseline. Good-looking shot from John Williams. Nice look. Pass off the mark.
Line.
Yep.
Little low to handle.
Second early turnover for Cascade. They average 13.5 per game. Smith, Eisenhoop. Pull-up jumper, knocked it down. Luke Smith's got all three Monrovia points. Alec Alderson with the basketball. The boy. It's back to Alderson. Monrovia doing a good job of switching on screens. They get an open look here. DuBois, three.
That's the way to do it right there, Sean. Great ball movement.
Penetration kick out gets it to work. This foul is going to be against Brock Stevenson. It's his first. This is our first time getting to come over here to Southmont. This is a beautiful school. I mean, it really is. We got kind of a little tour as we, you know, came in the front doors and got to come to the gymnasium and then see the opposite side. Some really cool things they got going on in here. They got a good video board.
Yeah, I love the gray down on the floor. Wow, Luke Smith has got the hot hand right now, Sean. Jump, little 8-foot jumper right there. Just beautiful.
Luke Smith, the leading scorer on the team, averages almost 21 points per game.
Last time these two teams met, Luke Smith only had 6 points.
How about that? Dalton DuBois knocks down another. He's got back-to-back threes for Cascade. 9-7. All three field goals for Cascade coming from behind the arc. Going to get a traveling violation here as Williams was looking at Smith and saw something else open up, shuffled the feet. You know the benefit of having a Luke Smith, he's only a junior. Exceptional score. 9-7. Build on their. You're going to get a foul here, reaching in.
Eisenhut.
And we'll get Trevor with his first. Alderson to inbound. Get it to Butler.
Nice. Oh, couldn't get it to go.
Yep, over the back. I'll tell you, I really like that play, though. Stevenson, last time we saw him penetrate and kick, that time defense kind of shifted towards the shooter, and he got a good look. Eisenhut to bring it up from Monrovia. Shot from the corner. And Smith continues to light it up.
Guess who?
8 points. And that gives Monrovia a one-point lead. I think he came to play tonight, Pete.
Definitely. Again, like I said, only 6 points against this team last time. He's lighting it up right now. He's making sure it counts.
Birch way downtown, no good.
Man, that was deep.
Kick to the corner, Seaver.
Beautiful.
You don't get any more open than that.
Woo, man.
13. Monrovia starts to heat up from the outside. See that man-to-man defense doing a really nice job against Cascade right now as well. They look back door, defense there. Sieber with hands. Eisenhut run out, little floater in the lane, count it.
Wow.
We're going to get our first time out of the game.
Nice job, Trevor. Came in pretty hot and he avoided the charge and just let a little floater go and nailed it.
15-9, early score. First timeout's a full one. We'll step aside as well. Be back with more basketball right after this.
Living with Endeavor's medical alert system. Contact emergency help or a loved one directly through the water-resistant two-way voice pendant. It's as easy as pressing a button to call for help in and around your home. The medical alert system is easy to use and connects directly to your landline telephone. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we help protect what you cherish most.
Welcome back here at Southmont High School. Already got some fans in the stands realizing they're on TV. 15-9, your early score here, sectional 44. Monrovia with a nice response. Cascade came out and hit three threes to get to that 9 points. But Monrovia has knocked down a couple triples themselves in the last few possessions. They lead this one by six.
Monrovia behind the leadership of right now having an excellent first quarter.
Little miscommunication there. Be another Cascade turnover, already three in the game. These two teams have had a little bit of a dry spell since their last sectional. For Monrovia, it's been 16 years. Their last one came in 2000 as Smith knocks it down again.
Luke Smith. Unconscious.
What a huge first quarter for him. Monrovia has doubled up Cascade in the first. I'll tell you, John Williams has been Evan Birch's shadow.
The Bulldogs right now playing excellent defense, getting out on the shooters, contesting every pass. They have got a good plan, and they've stuck with it throughout this first quarter. And you can see it, four turnovers now.
You know, really, Cascade has two threes from that man right there, and DuBois giving three. But I think if you're Monrovia, you'll live with that, won't you? Letting the big man step out and hit?
I think so. You're playing good defense right now, and you got to hope that he's not going to hit those all night long.
I mean, numbers tell you he's only a 22% three-point shooter now. He's hit three of them here. 18-12, Monrovia is going to look to hold for the final shot of the first quarter.
Again, Cascade, the first time these two teams, well, it was only 3 of 11 from beyond the arc, Sean.
Well, they've definitely broke that here in the first quarter, but they still find themselves down on the board.
That's all they've made are threes. That's it.
Sieber, floater, no good. DuBois got a chance.
Oh, man.
Nothing doing. After one, 18-12, your score. Back with more basketball from sectional 44 right after this.
Peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish.
Second quarter action here on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications. It's sectional 44 from Southmont High School. Monrovia jumped out to an early first quarter lead from some hot shooting.
Holy cow.
And it'll continue here in the second. Takes it down from the assist from Luke Smith.
That's four threes now for the Bulldogs and four for the Cadets. Wow.
We're talking about seeing the Splash Brothers in game two. We're getting some splashing going on right now from downtown.
Splash down the bottom of that net. That foul was on Davis, number 33.
That'll bring in number 30, Max Newman, for the Bulldogs. Austin Gates has checked in for Cascade. Good drive by Alderson, but he gets rejected. I believe it was Newman that got the block.
That'd be a turnover right there.
Loses it down on this end, though.
You know, Sean, Cascade, they were doing an excellent job when they were able to penetrate into the lane and kick it back out. So we're hoping to see some of that. Maybe that'll help them get back in. So that defense right now for the Bulldogs is tough. Another three.
That shot off the mark.
That seems to be the only shot that they can get right now. Again, make that effort to get in the lane. Bad pass.
Run out the other way. It's Smith with the bucket.
Luke Smith just wiped out that last out of his.
Well, You're going to get a foul here. I think it's against Newman, so it'll stay Cascade basketball. Birch to inbound, he'll get it. Into Stevenson, who finds DuBois. Drive
yes,
down
is.
The lane by Alderson, and that's a foul.
I like that call, good call. Set feet.
With it out top. Smith battling down low for position against Stevenson. He was calling for the basketball. They were unable to get the entry pass in. They find the junior here. Baseline. High shooting. Nope. Can't continue. Alderson pulls down the board.
There Birch, you go.
Down the lane.
Beautiful pass.
He'll find Gates.
Great assist.
Three on the way. Way too Ooh. Long that time. Newman, though, with the rebound. He's kind of been everywhere since he's checked in, B. Smith just needs a little space. That one dead on, but caroms out a little bit. He slipped.
Nice spin move.
Oh, yeah. Evan Birch down the lane. Count it.
Evan Birch starting to warm up.
Going to get a timeout. 23-16, your score. Monrovia out to this early lead. There's a good shot of Coach DuBois talking his team up in the huddle.
Evan Birch had 20 points last time he played against Monrovia, but I'll tell you another one who had a very good game, and that was number 24, Alec Alderson. Sean averages almost 7 points a game. He had 14 during that game on 5-of-5 shooting, and he went 4-of-4 from the free throw line. That's a perfect night.
Yeah, they need another performance like that to make sure that they get her done. They've got three players on the scoreboard right now. Dalton DuBois leads Cascade with 9. On the other side, it is Luke Smith. He's got, 13 points going so far here before the half?
That's it. He came up a little, kind of on the other end. I believe they have him on the bench now, maybe to just rest up, make sure he's okay.
Give him a little break. Zach Cottrell checked in for him.
Yeah, if you can hold this lead like that, you can afford to rest your starters. And got to get some good playing time now out of these guys who are coming in off the bench, giving you some good minutes, no turnovers. And hold that lead.
Good look inside. They got to kick it back out to Eisenhoop. Down the lane. Little bit of contact. No foul called. And a nice heads-up play by Alderson.
How about that? There you go.
That'll get your team fired up just a little bit. And immediately Luke Smith checks back in for Monrovia. Seems to be okay. Number 30. Michael Morris checks in for Cascade. And number 31, Dalton Smith, Monrovia as well. Nice pass, entry. Got blocked by the bottom of the backboard, though.
Boy, you cannot miss those. Those are just too easy. Got to get those. Looked like he's almost hesitant when he drove in there, like he was surprised that he was that open.
They're looking for DuBois down on the block. Spins, nice drop step. Too strong. Good job early on the glass in the first half. They're going to try to reward him here.
It's the second time we've seen that play. Just different result.
That was an easy foul they just called right there against Michael Morris at Cascade. Literally grabbed a hold of the arm of the player and just pulled him out of the way to keep him from getting the rebound.
That's one way to do it, right?
He'll check out of the game, but it's better than giving up the offensive rebound and putback.
That's it. There's a hot hand right there.
Williams with it now from Monrovia. 3:41 till we hit the halftime break. As always, halftime show headed your way. We'll get you some highlights and scoring recaps from the first.
Oh!
You're going to get a foul down low. Looks like they're going to get Zach Butler with his first. And they will.
That's Zach's first foul.
That'll send Sieber to the line. And before I could even jinx him, he jinxed himself there. 78% free throw shooting on the season, misses the first.
Yeah, and they haven't started out so hot from the free throw line now.
Original five back on the floor for Monrovia, their starters. Cascade with their original starting five on the floor as well. 8-point lead. Pete, part of the key, said first to 50. Right now, Monrovia almost halfway there. That pass in the lane.
Another turn.
Might have been kicked. Doesn't matter. Eisenhut misses on the other end, and you're going to get a foul against Sieber. Good shot of Chris Dubois.
Not sure if Trevor just had to adjust his shot on the way up.
Coach Dubois, you see on your screen right there, he won back to 05 in his first 2 years as a coach at Cascade. This Cascade team, they're 3-1 versus sectional opponents. That shot no good. Find themselves trailing here early. Got numbers, decides to take it himself, and he'll earn a trip to the free throw line.
Looks like they may have gotten number three, John Williams. Take a look one more time, just gets him on the arm.
First free throw attempt, no good. That's the first trip to the free throw line for Cascade in the game.
I was just bragging on Alderson. He misses his first one. Gets this one though.
1-2 at the line. Point lead. Clock. Apologize, a little bit of technical difficulties with our main camera tonight. Looks like it flashed black on the screen a few times. We'll try to get that corrected for you at halftime. This one takes. He'll kick it back out to Alderson. Gets trapped in the lane. Stevenson three.
Oh, boy.
No good. Batted around. Birch.
Oh,
and one. Evan Birch gets. 4 points, and he's headed to the free throw line.
Boy, what a play. What a fight underneath the basket for these guys. Boy, if you could roll that back, you could see how much action there was underneath there.
It was nice hands by Birch to come out with. That thing was like hot potato underneath there.
It was.
Birch's free throw, good. He's got 5 points, all of them coming here in the second quarter. And just like that, it's a 4-point game, P. That is a huge momentum boost if you're Cascade. Now you've got to get a stop on the defensive end.
know if you did mention Cascade with 6 sectionals, right? But they've never won a regional.
Have not.
I believe Monrovia with 2 of them.
It's been a little while for Monrovia. When speaking of the sectional run, 2000 was the last one, but they won 3 straight years. They won 98, 99, and 2000. 2 of those years, they took regionals as well in 99 and 2000.
There you go, yeah.
Their first sectional came all the way back in 1932. I'd love to tell you I know somebody from that team, but I don't. Sieber gets the free throw to go at the line.
I'm older than you, and I don't know anybody on that team.
Got the next one to go.
Was so, a nice looking shot there from the free throw line.
As far as gaps and sectional wins, though, their first one came, second one came in 42. They didn't win another one. Four.
Nope. Quite a while.
1996. Here. Going to be a full timeout. We'll take a break as well. 1:30 on your clock. Almost halftime. 6-point lead for Monrovia. We'll be back right after this.
World of television entertainment with Endeavor ETV. Get more than 350 quality TV channels, including HD, movies, sports, family programming, lifestyle, and local news and weather. Never miss a program with Endeavor Whole Home DVR. Stop a program in one room and continue watching TV in another. Enjoy video on demand and pay-per-view selections with over 2,000 titles. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more.
Welcome back here on MTC Sports. They called a full timeout. We went to the break, and they changed it to a 30. You got to love when they do that to us. Tried to sneak some commercials in. Didn't miss anything in the action, though. 6-point lead. Loose ball on the floor. Birch comes away with it. Du Bois. Well, he's thinking about those threes. I would, too, if you got 3 of them in the first quarter. Good cut, pass, not so much.
They've made an effort now to get a man right on him and keep a hand in his face, so he's been kind of quiet since that last one.
Smith going to pull it out. Coach Micah Elliott says one shot.
And my goodness, that is the fastest half of basketball I think we've seen all year.
And you're going to get a foul. And credit Eisenhut right there recognizing the switch. He gets Du Bois on him. And he's going to pick up another foul. That's his second one. So coach has got to get him out so that he doesn't pick up the third here with the final 20 seconds on the clock.
Du Bois wanted a push off, but there is no push off there.
Monrovia at the line. That shot no good. Leaving some points there. That was a key to victory. So it'll be Cascade potentially with a final trip here in the second quarter.
See if Birch does get this one.
Can they capitalize? Birch, wipe it off.
Oh!
They give him the charge. The fans right below us, the Cascade fans, are absolutely.
Man, take
upset.
A look one more time, Sean. To me, the ball, he's let it go. The ball's in the air and going in.
The foul is on the way down, and to me, the defender's too deep.
Wow. I tell you, I'm not a fan of that call one bit.
That one off the mark. Coach Du Bois, obviously upset, going to have a conversation with the officials as they head to the halftime locker room. 26-20, your score. We'll be back with a halftime show right after this.
Wow. College already.
Yeah. We gotta go.
I love you.
I love you too, Daddy. You're the one who saw. And thanks for everything.
Gratitude. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life. Communications continues to be the leader of technology in the communities we serve. We provide crystal clear voice, super fast internet, exciting television entertainment, security systems for home and business, medical alert systems, IT services, and our new 4G LTE wireless telephone service with nationwide coverage. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Welcome back here on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications. Good shot of the fans in the stands across the way. This first half of basketball has Monrovia on top of Cascade by 6. We welcome you into the Endeavor eShield Security Solutions halftime show. Pete, we've seen a good half of basketball. Both teams really going back and forth at each other. For Cascade early, every bit of offense came from behind the arc. 4 field goals in the first quarter, all of them threes. They started getting to the bucket in the second. How did they mix those two games? Because it was all threes, then it was no threes. They got to get both things going to really open up their offense.
Well, first off, Monrovia's defense, I thought, was outstanding in that first half. And they recognized that they were hitting them from deep, and they started getting out there and getting on those guys and getting a hand in the face, especially of Dalton DuBois. He had red hot hand early on. You said, here's a guy who only shoots, what, 27%?
22, I think.
22% from the outside, and he drills 3 threes, one right after the other. But for Cascade, they were having some success when they were able to penetrate into the lane or just be able to pass into there and then kick it back outside. I think in the second half, you'll see some more of that. They had some success there. Monrovia, for the most part, they're getting a job done. Outside, inside, they're doing a really good job. I think they stick to their game plan and continue to roll.
You know, going back to Dalton DuBois, he was 9 of 41 from behind the arc coming in. And he's, I think, 3 of 3 or 3 of 4 right now from behind the arc. And he leads Cascade right now with 9 points. He did pick up that second foul right before the break. So he'll have to be careful there for the first few minutes in the third quarter. Chipping in was Evan Birch with 5, and really, Pete probably should have 8 right now. We saw that play on the lay-in called for the charge and thought, honestly, that one should have been a blocking foul from our perspective.
It looked like that he went up, the ball goes in, and then when he comes down is when he gets into that player. He's got to have room to come down, like you pointed out. And, you know, really, Chris DuBois, good job of him biting his tongue. He made one comment and he just walked on. He knows how important that, you know, this game is, and he doesn't need any kind of foolish technical and to give this, you know, team any more, you know, ammo.
Right, absolutely. Scoring-wise for Cascade, we told you Dalton DuBois leads away with 9. Birch chipped in with 5. Brock Stevenson has got 3. Alec Alderson out of the starting lineup has 1. Austin Gates gave them their only points off the bench, and he's got 2. The other side of the court, Monrovia is led by Luke Smith with 13. He's been on fire. Cooled down a little bit there in the second with only 2 of those 13 coming there. Sieber has 6. John Williams with 5. Eisenhut with 2. Absolutely 0 points off the bench so far. But to this point, 6-point lead, they haven't needed it.
Not at all, no. I think they're getting a job done. They got their starters out there. That's who they're getting their points from. Now, they need to, if Luke Smith, if they get, you know, they're starting to, you know, slow him down a little bit, they're going to have to find somebody to step up and get some points, whether that's somebody coming off the bench, you know, maybe a Newman. Cottrell, we've seen him come in and play pretty decent. So it'll be interesting to see what they do here in the second half.
Free throw shooting in the first. Cascade only 2 free throw attempts. They went 1 of 2 at the line. On the other side for Monrovia, they go 4 of 7. We talked about that being a key to victory. And right now, Monrovia getting to the line a lot more, only hitting 4-7 so far. But when you're out shooting them 7-2, you're typically going to win those games when you spread that over the course of a basketball game. Take those numbers, you know, times two more quarters, and you're 8-14 versus 2-4.
Yeah, you love to get those free throw shots in. That's one of the keys to victory. You know, we thought that if it came down, this is a close game. You want to be able to step up the line. You want to get those. And right now, you know, Monrovia is doing a fantastic job of finding a way to get to that line and make those shots.
Right now, we're really on pace for exactly what these two teams do. Monrovia averages 53 points per game. They've got 26 right now. You double that up, there's 52. On the other side, 46 points per game for Cascade. They had 20 in the first half. It's going to do it for our halftime show. We'll step aside when we come back. Third quarter basketball action right here on MTC Sports.
Everywhere is a value-added entertainment option which gives Endeavor Television subscribers the ability to watch TV programs on their PC, laptop, tablet, or smartphone. When you subscribe to an Endeavor TV package, you receive select TV programming that is available in that package free of charge. You can view Watch TV Everywhere programs just about anywhere. All you need is an internet or Wi-Fi connection. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details about Watch TV.
Fast high-speed internet is only a click away. Through fiber optic technology, Endeavor Communications is able to offer internet speeds up to 1,000 megabits per second to stream movies, download music, watch TV and video clips, connect on social media, play games online, conduct online video conferencing, and is ideal for supporting all of your devices in your home or business. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Communications continues to be the leader of technology in our communities. We provide crystal clear voice, super fast internet, exciting television entertainment, security for home and business, medical alert systems, IT services for home or business, and our new 4G LTE wireless telephone service with nationwide coverage. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Connected with Endeavor eWireless. Endeavor offers affordable individual plans with unlimited voice and messaging and family share plans with your choice of data plans up to 20 gigabits. Endeavor eWireless runs on a quality 4G LTE network with nationwide coverage. Choose from popular smartphones. You can even bring in your own phone. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit weendeavor.com for more details about Endeavor eWireless plans.
Gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. Eshield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish.
The halftime buzzer just sounded here at Southmont High School. Cascade Cadets, Monrovia Bulldogs in the quarterfinals. 26-20, the early score. Monrovia up by six. Game two still to come. It'll be the North Putnam Cougars versus the Cloverdale Clovers. That one will follow this game here. Cascade will start with the basketball first. Trying to chop into this lead. We talked about how Cascade won the earlier matchup back on February 9th. That was only a four-point game. This one's still pretty close, too, and they start with a hot three. Stevenson now with 6 points. And that six-point lead cut to three really quick. Smith had that first hot start. He had 11 points in the first quarter. Only two since then. Into the lane, no good. No foul called. Cascade fans got their hands in the air going, where's that call? Good look. Count the bucket. Butler gets one to drop. Woo!
Wow. And that's Zach Butler's first points.
Well, you love it when the basketball has eyes, and you like it when the basketball players have their eyes on the basketball.
That's right. Look at that one. Great assist.
Butler can tie it up here. Free throw attempt, no good. It's still a one-point lead, but look at Cascade coming out, throwing the first set of haymakers here in the second half. That's a 5-0 run. Smith, baseline jumper.
He picks right back up.
Well, we say it every time we see a lefty that shoots as well as Luke Smith does. It just looks better coming out of a lefty's hand. Eisenhut the other way. Good hustle by Butler. They're going to say Monrovia basketball. I thought that Eisenhut got it knocked off of himself there.
Yeah, I did not see it, so.
Either way, three-point lead. They look inside. Sieber back outside. Eisenhut knocks down the three.
Man, I tell you what, that looked good all the way. Trevor Eisenhut, wow.
Pete, that just shows you what happens when you get the ball inside first.
Look at that young man.
Du Bois is unconscious tonight. He's got 12 points, four threes from behind the arc. He only had 9 on the entire season coming in.
Yeah, 10 points a game is what he averages. Four threes, just a sophomore.
Williams kicks to the corner to Sieber. Sieber picked up by Du Bois. Now this is where he's got to watch out.
They let him play in that one all the way down, didn't they? Wow, beating and banging.
Sieber with the lay-in, he's got 8. Look inside. Butler loses the handle on it. Monrovia with a chance to push this lead out a little further. It's back to 5 currently. Smith tries to make it 8. No good. Birch off the screen from Du Bois. Du Bois keeps kind of fading to that 3-point line. Good look to Butler. Too strong.
Big rebound.
Smith swings it around. Eisenhut hit one a minute ago.
Same spot.
He'll knock it down again. Just like that, he's got 8 points here.
Same results. Wow.
And it's an 8-point lead.
He's warming up. Again, I thought if, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I thought that if somebody, if Luke Smith started to get cold or if they were, you know, defense was stepping up on him, it's nice to see that you're, you know, Trevor's picking it up out there.
Cascade started on a 5-0 run since. It has been 10-3 in favor of Monrovia. Coach Rady, a good friend of the program, he talks about it. It's a game of runs. He'll tell you all the time. Teams are going to make runs at each other.
It's how you handle those runs. Shows what you're made of.
Alderson trying to lose Williams. Does. Good move. Gave it the kiss off the glass. Sieber, baseline. They get it back to him. And he knocks down another. His second three of the game. He's in double figures now with 11. Look inside to Birch. Birch spins on Williams, gets blocked from behind. Good help side defense from Davis. Smith,
yep.
Charge. Stevenson stood in and took that one. Boy,
wow.
He took a knee to the
My
chin,
goodness,
too.
Yeah, he's up there. You like to see them help each other up off the floor like that. And
brief timeout, so Brock can lace him up again quickly. Stevenson will bring it up. Bulldogs stay in that man-to-man defense. This is a Cascade team. You see that shot miss there.
I like that, though, getting inside, getting in the paint. If you got something, take it. If not, get the kick out. Get you an open look.
This is a Cascade team, Pete. They lost to Cloverdale in the sectional championship last year. They had the benefit of that first round bye. Got a win versus Monrovia. Got in that sectional championship game and then lost. Trying to battle their way back again. See how active Smith is in the lane. That's a great replay from our floor camera.
Rattles that one around.
Smith gets it to drop. He's got 16 now. Great job by our crew here tonight. Our director, Kevin Gashow, all the guys here behind the scenes at MTC Sports.
Oh, that one in and out.
Smith rattles that one in and out. Alderson with the kick out to DuBois. Cascade doing a lot of standing around right now offensively. Got to find some ball movement.
Oh, boy.
Miscommunication is Gates thought DuBois was going to the bucket.
DuBois got to not worry about the bad pass and just get down there and play some defense.
Newman kick out. Eisenhut. No.
That's that spot, though, he likes.
Newman with another rebound.
Back out to Luke. Let Smith set it up.
Newman, just a freshman from Monrovia. He looks pretty good out there tonight. I mean, not wowing you in the scoring column, but rebounds and setting good screens defensively.
Yeah, putting some good minutes in.
A good size for a young player.
Just
there
don't
he is.
Just don't want to turn over and you get things like that. Nice job. God, he's going to be a big kid, isn't he?
Set a screen and then slip to the bucket wide open, and you're going to get a timeout here by Cascade as the lead grows to 12, 42-30. Full timeout signaled for. We'll step aside as well. 12-point lead. More basketball headed your way when we come back.
Full timeout.
12-point lead right now for the Monrovia Bulldogs, trying to advance to the semifinal round Friday night. The winner of this game will take on the host school in the Southmont Mounties. Monrovia did not play Southmont during the regular season, and neither did Cascade. So nothing to really draw off of there from a previous matchup. Birch, DuBois, not quick on the trigger that time. I figured he would be after knocking down four of them.
Oh, yes.
Jump ball as Newman gets his hand on top of the basketball.
Well, I tell you what, Newman hardly even jumped there. He just put his hand right up on top of it. And watch this again, Sean. He just covers it and smothers it.
Back to live action. That shot missed by Alderson. Eisenhoop pull up in the lane, little floater. Looks like he may have gotten fouled. No call from the officials. Cascade with numbers. Stevenson in the lane, little scoop shot, no good. Eisenhoop will push now. Monrovia with numbers. Siever, no. Ball batted around down low, and the Cadets come out with it. Birch in the lane, finds nothing but white jerseys, which means all the Cadets are open. No good. Newman secures the board.
I thought DuBois was going to get another one.
You're going to get a foul out here on the floor.
Well, you get those, that little bump out in front. Man, they are letting them play, aren't they?
I don't know if the Cloverdale student section all traveled on the team bus here together, but they just all walked in the gymnasium together, and they look like, what was that? Is it minute it's work?
Construction workers right now, yeah. Kind of looks like us when we're out pulling cable.
Monrovia with the basketball. Final 10 seconds of play here in the third. That lead that was 6 at halftime is now 12. DuBois with the board. Chance to get another one from half court.
Oh!
And that one just rolls in and out. Almost got a highlight there. 12-point lead going into the fourth. Can the Bulldogs hold on? We'll find out in just a few short minutes here on MTC Sports.
Peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish.
Welcome back here, 42-30. That's a good shot of those Cloverdale student section as they'll get ready to cheer on their team.
Yeah.
When this one ends.
They're coming to work. Got the men at work and they're coming to work.
Eisenhoop kick out, Siever.
Ooh, boy.
Didn't hit anything.
Everything, yeah.
This is a young man that's already knocked down a couple of threes here in the game. Stevenson with the kick out. Find Alderson out top. Cascade being patient on offense here. Trying to find a good shot. Again, not a lot of motion. They find a cutting Alderson here. Nice play on
beautiful
the tail end
play
of that. Alderson with the first field goal in the fourth quarter. It's a 10-point lead. It's a takeaway by Cascade. They find DuBois. Ooh. He looks down low to Butler. Stevenson three. Just short. DuBois tried to pick him.
Yeah, you're not going to get that call too often, are you? Reaching in like that. Take a look one more time here, Sean. And yeah, you're going to get him with the body probably 9 times out of 10.
Coach Elliott looked right at Eisenhut and said, slow down. Pump the brakes, young man. We're good to go.
Yeah, play your game, right?
That ball loose on the floor. Got a jump ball here as players all on top of each other. Evan Burch just trying to make sure that his lower extremities were still intact there.
Well, since you brought up Evan Burch, let's just go ahead and throw it out. Evan Burch was named All-Western Indiana Conference player. And then we can't mention him without mentioning Austin Gates, named to the Indiana Academic All-State football team.
That's awesome. Congratulations to both of those guys. It's always good when your work in the classroom or your work on the basketball floor is acknowledged at the conference level or the state level.
And one thing I always like to point out is we ask for those. We want to put those things out on the air. We want you to know about how smart these students are. They're not just basketball players, but they do other things. We want to know what they're doing in the community.
Williams goes high off the glass and rattles one in.
Boy, he got that one over Birch, didn't he? Man.
Back to a 12-point lead. Cascade's got to find some offense here. Butler, nice pass to DuBois, and he got the lay-in.
DuBois with his first deuce of the game.
14 points now for him. Cascade bringing the pressure. Monrovia able to break, and now they'll set up their offense. Cascade not just going to let it hold it out top, though. They're going to come out and pressure the basketball.
Yeah, I don't think you want to – you don't necessarily need to foul, but do pressure the ball. Try to force some mistakes.
Oh, Smith,
oh man.
With a just knockdown mid-range game in this one.
He has been on fire.
18 points for Smith.
He's hit up in three-point land, but he's had some – two-point buckets have just been beautiful little 8 to 10 footers.
Monrovia with numbers. They get it ahead to Seaver, and he'll finish it off.
Good unselfish basketball.
13. Mm. Birch gets into the lane. Takes a little bit of contact. They'll earn a trip to the free throw line. We said first to 50 probably wins. Monrovia right now 2 points away from that, so obviously still 4 minutes on the clock with a 14-point lead. Cascade's got to take advantage of opportunities like this.
Evan Birch had 20 points the last time these two teams met, and he struggled here tonight, Sean. They've done a very good job on him defensively.
Just 6 points in the game. He misses the second of two free throws there.
A jump ball, and I'm not sure who it'll belong to.
Possession's going to be Monrovia.
Monrovia. Yeah, go with the Bulldogs.
Full court pressure. They get it into Eisenhut. Spins out of there. And they break it just like that. They made that look easy.
They did.
Seaver all the way with a lay-in.
I'd still be down here trying to get the ball in, Sean.
That spin from Eisen, who really did it, as he was able to split two defenders. Cascade down by the largest margin they faced all night, 15. They need this to go, and they get it. Stevenson trying to shoot him back in. He's got nine, all three of his field goals from beyond the arc. Sieber, mid-range jumper, no.
I can't blame him for taking that.
Going to push. He gets stripped, taken away by the Bulldogs. And now a foul on DuBois, and that's number four.
Yeah. Yeah, unfortunately, the offensive player stopped, and DuBois kind of ran into him, you know, and made it an easy call for the referee.
Monrovia just going to back it out here, really, and take as much time off the clock as they can on this possession. I don't think you'll see a shot, Pete, unless it's a layup or a free throw. He'll lay up. The foul's on the ground. Still ways to go before we hit the bonus. Got a few fouls to give.
Yeah, and the only reason I think Smith went to the basket that time is because the ball was out of his hands and going that way. They brought some players together down there. It looks like they're talking to him. Yeah, get a nice slap of the hands. These guys really want to win, you know. I mean, they put a lot of heart in it, and sometimes it just gets a little heated.
Yeah, you hate to see your season
end. They're bumping around right now, and they're still trying to separate them, Sean.
Well, they're still waiting for play to happen here.
Birch and Eisenhut going at it.
Because the boy fouled out. That was his fifth foul.
Oh, I had him for four.
Well, yeah. He did, but then the foul down here on Smith is who they gave it to, so that gave him
You're
five.
You're right. I'm sorry.
This one taken away. Butler. Somehow the ball stays in bounds. Stevenson tries to hit another. Rattles it home. Trying to breathe life back into these cadets. Down by just nine now with 2:44 on the clock. We're going to get a full timeout, which allows us to take a break and catch our breath as well. 50-41. More basketball headed your way when we come back. For you, is that this life becomes all that you wanted to? Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, lots of sad things to get me. Fifty to 41, your score. Sectional 44 coverage at Southmont High School. Pete Gasho, Sean Walker, calling the game for you this evening. We still got another one to come. North Putnam and Cloverdale. They will take the court following the conclusion of this one. We got 2:44 on the clock, and it is a 9-point lead right now for the Bulldogs. Cascade, though, on a little bit of a run. This lead was 15 just a few minutes ago. Monrovia, no need to be in a hurry here. Williams to Smith. Obviously, Monrovia going to work some clock here. At some point in time, Cascade will have to think about fouling and getting this closer to the bonus. Putting them at the line. There's one. That's foul number six, so that'll put Monrovia in the bonus on the next foul. We'll have one more out-of-bounds play here. And there's the foul right away as they get it into Williams. And that's a good job of understanding who's on the floor. Williams, a 54% free throw shooter. You've got him and Eisenhut out there right now. Eisenhut, 47%. And then McCoy Davis, 45%. The two people you don't want to put at the line are Smith and Sieber.
Yeah, you foul the right guy, but unfortunately, Birch was the guy who had to foul him.
That's number four for him. Williams goes to the line and knocks down the first. He'll try to get the second here.
Wow.
And he does.
Stepping up big.
Back to an 11-point game. Butler, a couple of ball fakes, gets the defender in the air. Layup, no good.
No tie up.
Davis will be fouled.
Oh, no, he'll be fouled.
I think they're going to call it on Butler. Nope, it's going to be on number 30. That'll be Michael Morris. That's his second foul. McCoy Davis misses the front end of the one and one.
Still a chance here.
Three, Stevenson. Well, he's had the high hand. There's Birch. Put back. 8 points now for Evan. 9-point game. Eisen immediately tries to get it out of his hands. And Williams will go back to the line. He knocked down two a moment ago. He's got 9 points in the game. Right around a season average on the season.
I think Williams is a senior, you know. He's been here before. Even though his free throw percentage isn't the best, he's a guy you want at the line, though. I mean, he can handle this pressure.
I think that's why, honestly, Pete, the high school sports and even college basketball is so endearing to fans. Is when the players get to those senior years, you hate to see them lose. You hate to see them come off that court for the final time. This shot will rattle around and go in for Alderson.
Nice little spin move.
Butler with the foul. That'll send Sieber to the line.
I believe that'll be two on Butler.
Even though South Putnam.
That's his third, I'm sorry.
Will not play until Friday. They are here. They're interested in this next game to see who they're going to take on. Sieber knocks down the first free throw. Sieber puts it back to 11. Cascade's got to go quick. Birch is three, no good. Smith trying to dribble out of pressure. Got to get it across.
He does. He just blows through everybody.
And again, Cascade really doesn't. They don't want to foul him. You're going to get a timeout. 30-second timeout taken by Coach Elliott. For these cadets, you look down through their roster. You've got a few players coming back. You got Evan Birch that'll be back next season. DeBoy, a young player as well. The seniors that you're going to graduate that we've seen play in the game here tonight are Stevenson, Zach Butler,
Morris.
Michael Morris will come out, and Gates.
Yep.
So you're going to lose four of those players that have gotten quite a bit of playing time in this game here tonight. But a complement of young players will come in and have to step up and take their place again next season.
I got a lot of juniors and sophomores in there, so they should be able to field a pretty decent team next year.
But you're returning your top two scorers off of this team, and that's a huge benefit.
It is. Good leadership.
I don't know how that ball even stayed in bounds, but good defense there from Cascade. That was Garrett Compliment, number five, who came into the game. Nearly had the takeaway. He'll pick up the foul here. Williams will go back to the line where he's 4-for-4 here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah. He's been rock steady right there. Look at that one. Rolls that one in, too. I'm telling you.
Make that 5 for 5.
Senior guard like that, that's leadership right there. Stepping up, making those free throws when it counts.
57-45, 12-point lead for the Bulldogs. Make that 13. Williams continues to remain perfect at the line. Compliment gets it to Alderson. Going to get the shot off here. Why not? It's been a hot shooting night from Cascade from behind the arc. Unfortunately, they need about 4 or 5 more on the scoreboard. But that one, that might bring some more rain to our area. The benefit of some high ceilings in here.
Man, that was way out there.
Even saw Eisenhut walk by and kind of hit him on the side and be like, said nice shot to him. Williams again at the line. His free throw shooting has been phenomenal here in the fourth quarter.
He says, come on, just, yeah, foul me. I only average almost 8 points a game. I'll get them all right here.
And this is a nice move by Coach DuBois. He's going to put his seniors back on the floor.
Oh, look at that.
Williams gets another.
4 for 4.
15 points in the game for Williams. Compliment going to let another 3 go.
Oh.
That one off the mark. Saved by Gates, but to the Bulldogs.
Aw.
And now you're going to get, you put them on the floor so you can pull them back off and give them their moment. I absolutely love this. These seniors, they've given you blood, sweat, and tears for 4 years.
Oh, I like this too. No doubt about it. I think it's great. It's good for the fans. It's good for the parents.
McCoy Davis at the line knocks down his first free throw. And the Cascade fans stand up right away and say, thank you, seniors. And that's going to be the chant from the parents. Hats off to that group of young men that will come out of the game wearing that Cascade jersey for the final time. Davis gets 1 of 2. Birch. We'll try to add one more before. Can't get it to go, and Rovi will hold.
Yep.
And that's going to be your final. 61-48. Monrovia over Cascade. They will avenge a loss from just a couple of weeks ago. By coming in here today and pulling out the victory by 13. We'll step aside. When we come back, we'll wrap things up with the postgame show here on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications.
Speed internet is only a click away. Through fiber optic technology, Endeavor Communications is able to offer internet speeds up to 1,000 megabits per second to stream movies, download music, watch TV and video clips, connect on social media, play games online, conduct online video conferencing, and is ideal for supporting all your devices in your home or business. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Provides outstanding IT and computer-related services for your home or business. Whether you need a simple home PC tune-up or a large-scale network installation for your business or your municipality, Endeavor eTechs is your final destination for all of your IT needs. Maintenance agreements are available and services open to members and non-members alike. Call 1-877-524-9109 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
I don't think of this as a high school weight room. It's more like a high school classroom. I'm learning how to manage my time here. I'm learning that it's important to have goals and that it takes persistence and commitment to reach them. And I'm learning that the best way to lead is by example.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Welcome back here to Southmont High School. There's some Mounties fans. Their team won't play till Friday, but they're still here enjoying the game, doing a little cleanup out on the floor right now.
Crew.
As game one has come to a conclusion. 61-48 your scores. We wrap things up. Pete Gastro, Sean Walker here. Pete, 13-point win from Monrovia. They avenge an earlier season loss to Cascade. Really pretty good game and a good game plan from them coming in. Your final thoughts on this one?
Yeah, they got great scoring from Luke Sieber and Luke Smith. They did a fantastic job. And then the senior, John Williams, really stepped up big at the end. And congratulations to the Monrovia Bulldogs for winning and moving on to play this Friday.
Dalton DuBois led Cascade with 14 points. Brock Stevenson pitched in with 12. Those were the two that were in double figures. Birch had 8. He was knocking on the door. On the other side for Monrovia, Pete just mentioned it. They were led in scoring by Luke Smith with 18. Sieber finished with 17. But our player of the game tonight, that's going to be John Williams. 54% free throw shooter. He comes in the fourth quarter and knocks down 8 straight free throws to not really give Cascade a chance to close that gap. So hats off to John Williams and the Monrovia Bulldogs. We're going to step aside. That's going to do it for this one. Monrovia will move on. They will face Southmont on Friday. That game scheduled to start at 6 p.m. We will have it for you live on mtcsports.net. Next game, we're going to step aside briefly. When we come back, though, we will have North Putnam versus Cloverdale. It'll be game 2 of the quarterfinal matchups from sectional 44.